They make resistors where the resistance changes as a function of temperature. They also make resistors where the resistance changes depending upon the amount of light falling on the resistor. We're going to be using a light-dependent resistor later on in this video in order to build a sensing circuit. I want to introduce two different possible sensing circuits. The first one I want to introduce here is the potential divider. Let's take a look at the circuit. If we're using a sensor where the resistance depends on whatever we're trying to sense, then the output voltage that we measure in this circuit is going to change as a function of whatever it is that we're trying to sense. Let's go ahead and write the equation for the output voltage of this particular potential divider. For the sake of describing this circuit, let's assume that the nominal resistance of our sensor is just R. The real resistance that we measure is going to be R plus or minus some other resistance. Let's call the change in our sensor due to the environment, or whatever it is that we're trying to sense, R sub delta. This could be a negative number because whatever we're trying to sense might cause the resistance to go down rather than to go up. This equation describes the output voltage in terms of that change in resistance, R sub delta. Vin and R are constants in this circuit. What we actually measure in this circuit is the output voltage. We're going to be using a voltmeter to measure that voltage. But that's not what we really want to know. What we really want to know in this circuit is the value of that resistance. This R delta is the value that we'd like to determine. Because this equation relates the output voltage to R delta, we can definitely use this circuit as a sensor. We just measure the output voltage and then use the equation to determine R delta. But there are a couple of problems that I'd like to point out with using this particular circuit as a sensor. The first is that our output voltage has a built-in DC offset. If the R delta is zero, then we're going to measure some value for the output voltage. If the R delta is very small, then the output voltage is going to be varying across a large DC offset. The second problem with this particular sensing circuit is that it's sensitive to noise. If we don't know our input voltage very well, then whatever uncertainty that's associated with that input voltage is going to show up when we measure our output voltage. Let's look at another circuit called the Wheatstone Bridge that helps eliminate, or at least improve to a large extent, both of these problems. The output voltage in a Wheatstone Bridge is a type of measurement called a differential measurement. We have here, at the output voltage, a difference of two potential dividers. We can see that voltage V1 is just half of the input voltage because of the potential divider set up by these two resistors here on the left side of the circuit. Voltage V2 can also be determined through the voltage divider set up by the sensing resistor and the resistor R here at the top part of the circuit. Let's again assume that our sensing resistance has a nominal value of R plus some offset resistance due to the environmental variable that we're trying to measure. Our output voltage is the difference between these two voltages. If we look at the resulting equation, we can see that the Wheatstone Bridge solves the two problems present in the potential divider. First of all, you'll notice that if the Wheatstone Bridge is balanced, that is, if the sensor is at its nominal value, then the output voltage is zero. That means we don't have any large DC offset. Voltage measurements tend to be more accurate if they don't have a large DC offset to contend with. You might also notice that any noise present in my input voltage is going to be canceled out when the Wheatstone Bridge is balanced. In order to illustrate both of these properties of the Wheatstone Bridge, I'd like to graph the output voltage versus this R delta that we're trying to measure for both the potential divider and the Wheatstone Bridge. In order to do that, we'll be assuming that the resistors are all 1 kilo-ohm resistors, and we'll assume that our power supply or input voltage here is set to 1 volt. We're plotting the output voltage here versus R delta. First, take a look at the blue line. This represents the situation when the power supply is at 1 volt. If our R delta equals zero, then we should measure 0.5 volts at the output. As the R delta increases or decreases, we'll see a change in the output voltage. These two other curves on the graph here represent the situation when we have a problem with our input voltage. This could happen, for example, if the input voltage or the power supply voltage is either noisy, unstable, or if we don't know it too accurately. This green curve represents the situation when the input voltage is 5% higher than what we expect it to be. And the red curve represents a situation when the input voltage is 5% less than we expected it to be. Let's go ahead and plot the output voltage versus R delta relationship for the Wheatstone Bridge sensor. As you can see, the situation is much improved now compared to the potential divider. When the Wheatstone Bridge is balanced, any error in the input voltage will not show up in our measurement of the output voltage. This allows the Wheatstone Bridge to give us a more accurate value, ultimately, for the R delta that we're trying to measure. Secondly, because we don't have this 0.5 volt DC offset present in the Wheatstone Bridge, we wind up with a more precise measurement of our R delta 2. The three curves plotted here with the Wheatstone Bridge correspond to exactly the same variations in the input voltage that we plotted over here with the potential divider. As you can see, the Wheatstone Bridge gives us a much more accurate measurement of the output voltage and consequently the R delta that we're trying to measure compared to the voltage divider, because any noise that might show up in our input voltage is not going to show up in our output voltage, at least when the Wheatstone Bridge is balanced. Secondly, the Wheatstone Bridge is going to give us a more precise measurement of our output voltage and consequently our R delta than the potential divider circuit will, because we don't have this DC offset of 0.5 volts here in the Wheatstone Bridge. In a moment, we're going to go over to the bench and put together both a potential divider and a Wheatstone Bridge, which can measure changes in ambient lighting. We're going to be using a circuit element called a light-dependent resistor. The light-dependent resistor does just what its name says it does. The resistance changes depending upon the amount of light falling on the circuit, but we're going to be measuring the voltage rather than the resistance. Our light-dependent resistor has a nominal resistance of about 120 kiloohms. So when we put together these two circuits over at the bench, we'll be using 120 kiloohm resistors to fill out the circuits. We're going to be doing two experiments here at the bench. We're going to see how the voltage across the light-dependent resistor changes as a function of the lighting conditions. We're first going to try the potential divider configuration, and then we're going to try the Wheatstone Bridge configuration. We'll be using the power supply here, fixed to 5 volts, and we'll be measuring the voltage across the light-dependent resistor. Let's first turn on our 5-volt supply. We can see that under current lighting, we're measuring 2.02 volts. I'm going to turn on the light here, and let's see how much that voltage changes. The voltage is now 1.79 volts. The voltage with the light on is 88% of the voltage without the light on. Let's try the Wheatstone Bridge configuration now. I'm going to shut off our meters and put together the new circuit. We have the light-dependent resistor in a Wheatstone Bridge configuration now. Let's go ahead and turn on our power supply and measure the voltage across the Wheatstone Bridge. Without our light on, we're measuring a voltage of 0.48 volts. With the light on, we now have a voltage of 0.69 volts. The voltage with the light on is 1.46 times the voltage in ambient lighting. As we can see, having the light-dependent resistor in the Wheatstone Bridge configuration makes this circuit more sensitive because we get a larger percentage change in the voltage with and without the light on. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.